Introduction to Poetry, English Literature, Pike, Ted Hughes, Short Questions with Answers. Question 1. How does Ted Hughes create a sense of horror in Pike? Answer. Ted Hughes creates a sense of horror in Pike by using words related to terror and fright. He describes the fish as green tigering the gold. That suggests its resemblance to tigers, color and predatory nature. Then the poet says that pikes are killers from the egg and they have malevolent agent green. They move with submarine delicacy and horror. They look ferocious for their jaws hooked, clamp and fangs in them. A life subdued to its instrument. The poet describes two events to focus on the cannibalism of the pike. In both the cases, the strongest one ate of the others. The poet says that indeed, they spare nobody. Finally, the description of the pike's fishing in an event in an ancient pond is scary and horrific. The ominous dark atmosphere of the surroundings and the mysterious existence of the pike made the pike's hair frozen on its head. Thus, a sense of horror runs throughout the poem. Question 2. What purpose does the poem Pike serve? Answer. Ted Hughes is very fond of animal imagery and has written a number of poems on animals. However, he has not written poems on animals for the sake of his love for animals. He uses animals and the animal world as metaphor for the human world, where violence and cruelty is the common is very common. In Pike, the poet highlights the cruelty prevalent in the animal world. It is the fittest that survives, like the 4.5 inches long pike that eats off its companions. In another event, in a fight to eat each other, both died. Human beings are also driven by the urge to succeed in all cost. They fight, struggle, and become heinous to bear their opponents. The strongest man succeeds, just like the strongest pike that survives. So the purpose of the poem is to illustrate the animal quality of human beings. Question 3. Comment on the structure of the poem Pike. Answer. Pike is a poem of 44 lines divided in 11 stages, each consisting of 4 lines. Again, it can roughly be divided into 3 parts. First, 2 stages have been used for physical description of the pike. From stanza 3 to 7 have been used to suggest its inborn qualities. The last 4 stanzas present the pike's ominous, mysterious existence in the larger human world. Though the lines of the poem look regular, they do not have equal number of foot. The line length vary from 6, line 17 to 12, line 21 syllables. This difference between appearance and reality seems to suggest that under the camp surface lies dangerous cannibalism. The poem does not have end rhyme. The poet uses here speech rhythms that has helped him heighten the cruelty and tension that run throughout the poem. Question 4. Explain the main theme of Pike. Answer. Darwin's controversial theory of survival of the fittest is the main theme of Pike. Ted Hughes' poetic presentation of this poem is quite convincing. Poem vividly captures the violence and cruelty prevalent in the animal world. The pike is a predator. It lives on another fish. Its killing instinct is inborn. Killers prevail. It inherits malevolent agent green by birth. From the prehistoric period, it has the same cannibalistic nature. The speaker once kept 3 small pieces of this species in a glass jar. He found that one mysteriously disappeared, and finally there was only one. He discovered that the strongest one of the 3 ate of the other 2. Similarly, on another occasion, he found in a willow herb 2 of them dead in their effort to eat each other. In other words, the pike spare nobody. The poet reflects that there is continuous struggle for survival in nature, including the human world. This treatment of natural cannibalism is anti-romantic. Question 5. What is the significance of the incident of three small pieces of the pagan glass jar? Answer. The incident of the three small pieces of the pie kept aspects in a glass jar is very significant in the sense that it reinforces the theme of the survival of the fittest. The speaker presents it with anecdotal value. Once they kept three pieces of the pie in a glass jar, one was 3 inches, the second one was 4 inches, and the third one was 4.5. They fed them with fry. Suddenly, one of them disappeared, and finally there was only one. It is understood that the surviving one ate of the other two. Ted Hughes describes this anecdote to heighten the cannibalistic nature of the pack. It is evident in the description of the incident that the strongest of the three won the struggle for survival, defeating the weaker two. This is the truth in nature, including human world, where the stronger ones survive, defeating the weaker ones. Question 6. Explain the significance of the line, one jumped past its gills down the other's gullet, in the context of the poem pack. Answer. This is a line of the second anecdote used in the pack. The line is very significant in the sense that it highlights the main theme of the poem. The speaker once found in the willow harp two of the species. They were dead and dry. Each of them was over 2 feet long and 6 pounds in weight. Evidently, one of them tried to gulp down the other but failed. As a result, both of them died. Ted Hughes uses this incident to explain the cannibalistic nature of the pack. The pack is born with malevolent grin. Nothing has changed its inherent killing nature. It spares nobody. The strongest of the packs lives on the weaker ones. Thus, the fittest of them survives at the cost of the others. The quoted line is at the center of this anecdote that illustrates the theme of the survival of the fittest. Thank you, viewers, for watching my video.